Hello, hello, everybody, and thank you for joining us with Agile Team Live. I am Dana, and I will be your host for this lovely evening. Now, today is actually our third edition of Agile Team Live, and we have the absolute honor of having the Michael Verpin Trio and Dasha Logan with us tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be amazing. I heard the rehearsals. Woo! Now we are actually streaming live from Agile Team itself across three different platforms on Facebook Live, Instagram Live, and also YouTube Live. But ladies and gentlemen, if you want the best audio visual experience, make sure you head on over to our YouTube Live. The link is on our Facebook Live video itself, or you can just simply key in Agile Team on YouTube and you should see the little video over there saying that we are now live. And you know, just a tip from me, I had this last week, the best experience ever. If you're using a desktop, if you could just plug it into a TV or, you know, just hook up your audio speakers and stuff, trust me, the experience is really different. You will thank me later, okay? Now, today, our initiative here in Agile Team was actually set up during MCO itself. We went live on IG for 33 days in an effort to raise donations for our performers who have been badly affected by this pandemic, and we managed to raise 15,000 ringgit. That was absolutely incredible, and we just want to say our heartfelt thank you to all of you who have made your donations. 100% of the proceeds will go all to our performers, and if you'd like to make a contribution, you can do so at our website. It's www.agileteam.com. All the information will be there, and we just want to say thank you in advance for those of you who plan to contribute. Thank you so much for your kindness and generosity. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you know what? I really recommend that you get a drink of your choice, get comfortable, whether it's on your sofa or in bed or, you know what, anywhere in your house, because you must be prepared to listen to the amazing jazz tunes tonight. In fact, they're already ready behind me, so I just don't want to say no more, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, presenting to you the Michael Verpin Trio. Thank you.
good evening. Thank you very much for joining us on all the various platforms. We began the set with tune we just played called All Square. It's a composition of mine. And normally at this point in a live performance, I would introduce the band. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. We have on drums, Please Give It Up at Home. I think we can hear you if you make a loud enough noise. Give It Up for Cliff Wong on drums. We'd like to call up on stage the star of tonight's show. Please give it up for Dasha Logan.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, the Michael Verpin Trio. Very good evening to everyone at home. Thank you for joining us. This song's for all of you.
Best, but I only want to go there as a guest, cause I love
Home. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Michael Virpin on piano, Tasnim on the bass, and Cliff on the drums. I can hear you guys clapping. I feel it. The moon and under earthquakes boom in the silence of my lonely room. I think of you night and day, day and night. Under the hide of me, there is, oh, such a hungry yearning burning inside of me. And this torment won't be through till you let me spend my life making love to you day. Was night and day for you. Ooh. Here's a song called Moon Dance. Well, it's a marvelous night for a moon dance, with the stars up above in your eyes. A fantabulous night to make romance, 'neath the cover of October skies. And all the leaves on the trees are falling to the sounds of the breezes that blow. And I'm trying to keep to the calling of your heartstrings that play so low. And all the night magic seem to whisper and hush, and all the soft moonlight seems to shine.
I can't wait till the morning has come. And I know that the time is just right. And straight into my arms you will run. And when you come, my arms will be waiting to make sure that you're never alone. There and then all my dreams will come true to you. There and then I will make you my own. Every time, oh, I touch you, how you tremble and you sigh. I know how much you want me that you can't hide.
Moondance. That was Moondance. Always waits for kids. Porter from the musical The New Yorker. Classic standard for you. Love for sale. Appetizing young love for sale. Love that's fresh and still unspoiled. Love that's only slightly soiled. On the piano, ladies and gentlemen.
Young love for sale. If you want to try somewhere.
Up next is a song I grew up with from the movie Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory.
There's nothing to it. there is no life I know to compare with pure imagination. Living there, you'll be free if you truly wish to.
Thank you very much. That was pure imagination. It's very nice. Okay, we're going to do an Aretha Franklin song, and I'm very excited to do it. And here's an interesting song that's now probably a little bit creepy, but it's still such a lovely love song.
Come back to me, that's what
People did that, now you'd be thrown into jail for stalking. Please don't sleep outside my house.
One note, huh?
Cool, yes. We're gonna do this really fun song. This one is called One Note Samba.
This is just a little something.
note, Samba. Thank you very much. It's a Michael Verpin arrangement. All right, we got one more song before we take a short break. Verpin on the piano, ladies and gentlemen.
Where the nights are filled with peace. Ba ba ba, dum dee dum dee dum ba.
Michael Verpin on the piano, Tasim on the bass, Cliff on the drums. My name is Dasha. We'll be taking a short break.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Michael Verpin Trio featuring Dasha Logan. Now, for those of you guys who are just tuning in right now, please do not go anywhere just yet. We're just taking a really short intermission for our performance to have a short break. Now, performing is no easy task, okay? They really need to really chill out, you know? They're using so much energy to perform their best for you. And of course, because of that, we're going into a short Q&A session. You know, we just want to pick their brains a little bit. So if you want, you guys can prepare by shooting your questions onto any of the platforms in the comment section. Now, first up, I want to get Dasha up here. Where's she at? So, Dasha, we're just going to give you a couple of questions to answer because some of the people at home just want to know a couple of things about you, you know? Let's get to know you a little bit.
Okay.
Now, everyone, I know you can't see it online, but everyone's like, oh, Dasha, so beautiful, such an incredible voice. And I know that as a performer and a musician, you tend to get your inspiration and you're influenced or inspired to get into music. So I just want to know, how did you get into music and specifically singing?
Well, I sang from a very young age. And then I sang in kindergarten. I sang in primary school, secondary school, and so on and so forth. I just always enjoyed singing. Once you put a mic in my hand, no, never going to get it back. Even if it wasn't plugged into anything.
That's absolutely amazing, though. But do you get any vocal training in between, or was it just in you?
The interest to sing was always in me, and I was very lucky that I was given the opportunity to perform professionally at the age of 16, 17 in Penang with this lovely friend of mine, a very close friend of mine now. Then she was my boss, now she's my good friend. And yeah, she gave me the platform to realize how much I loved singing. And then I was, okay, I need some vocal training. Then I went for classes after that. But other than that, I just always just, can I sing?
Wow, so it's always been in you. And you can really see it, like even from the corner, from afar at the back, I could see you were just so passionate about it and you were just so into the music. It's incredible to watch live. So I just want to ask, after this MCO, how does it feel to be coming back to perform? It must be a little weird.
It's interesting because for some reason I'm a lot more nervous performing because I know there's more people watching over there and I can't see you, so I don't know your reaction. Yeah, it's a little bit more nerve-wracking than usual, and also because it's been almost 70 days since my last performance.
Yeah.
So my muscle, I realized my vocal muscle memory is a bit, no, it's not quite there. Forgot some stuff. So I'm like, don't forget, sing higher here. So it's interesting to be here, but I'm just so happy to be doing this. And thank you, Jiaotim and Michael Verpin, for including me in tonight's show.
Honestly, we are so honored to have you here and grateful to have you be a part of this alive. Guys, you may not know this, but when we were talking during her rehearsal, I said, you sound so good. And she told me, actually, I feel very rusty already. It's been so long. And I can only imagine if this is your rusty, how amazing you must be on an absolutely good day. It's incredible. Now, okay, this is going to be a weird question. I was just a little curious about this as well.
I like it.
Was it a little weird getting ready for tonight?
It was, 100%. I'm so used to my usual timing, so my friends and my musicians always know that I do my makeup and I do my vocal warm-ups at the same time. So I take about half an hour to get ready. But today, I was like, oh, I don't know if I remember how to put makeup on because I haven't done this in 70 days. And I was like, am I supposed to put eyeliner first? So that was weird. And then I brought my dress and I said, I didn't bring a backup dress, which is what I'm supposed to do. And then I started warming up my voice early in the morning just to make sure I didn't under-warm my voice. So yeah, it's only been 70 days. It shouldn't be such a big difference, but it is. 70 days of not performing as regularly as I used to makes a difference. So getting back into it.
Honestly, I really wanted to ask because again, I saw you get ready in like 20 minutes. She put on a dress, put on makeup. Honestly, she's so beautiful. She doesn't really need much. Seriously, guys, she probably could go with a bare face. But I was like, how did this girl get ready in like 20 minutes? Here I am thinking, how do I straighten my hair? What is this eyeliner?
Let's not even talk about the hair. This one took a while. So, no, it's just basically just me doing this like,
I feel you.
It's like, camera far away, don't come too close.
Now, you did mention Michael before this. Now, I'm guessing this is not your first time performing with the trio. So how long have you guys been playing together?
I've been playing with Michael for, he would say too long, but for 10 years now. 10 years we've been working together.
10 years?
I think so. But I think. No. Might be wrong. Our first show together might have been about 10 years ago, and then we started working regularly about 7-8 years ago. So yeah, I think the first time I worked with him was for the Michael Jackson tribute, and we were doing one song together. And it was a whole different experience from what I'm used to in Penang, which is in Penang, I'm a small island, everybody talks about Michael Rupin, and I don't know who that is. And I come to KL, and I watch him walk into the club, and I'm like, and everybody's like, okay, let's go to work. And I'm like this 23-year-old girl like, la, 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 acting a fool on stage, and he just goes, jang. And I'm like,
but honestly, you guys sound so flawless together. And now that we know that you guys have been working together for 10 years, that explains it all. Okay, Dasha, I think I want to give you a little break. Just enjoy yourself. Chill out a little bit. Because speaking of Michael Verpin, I just want to get the trio up here as well so that we can pick their brain instead. Come on over. We have Michael, we have Tasnim, and we have Cliff. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you're just joining us, I just want to point out that today's performance, our live, everything we do here at Jatim on this live is actually towards this initiative that we have. We are trying to raise donations to our performers who have been struggling during this pandemic. And of course, all the donations that you give will be going straight to the performers themselves. And if you'd like to make a donation, you can do so at www.jiaotim.com. Guys, you guys don't know how much love you guys have been getting online. Everyone's been doing like thumbs up, virtual applause, a lot of hearts. In fact, my mom actually dropped me a message. She's watching and she's like, oh, you're hosting for Michael Verpin. He's famous. These guys are so good. So you guys are getting so much love from home. And I just wanted to ask as well, how does it feel for you guys to be performing under this circumstance?
Oh, gosh. Sorry. I guess it's a bit awkward and all, like without an audience and stuff like that. And initially, we thought, like, you know, we're just going to get up and do our own thing and all. But once we started getting up on stage and we kind of felt the pressure, like, oh, my God, we're actually live on screen and all like that. But after a couple of songs, we are pretty all right. Yeah, we kind of got used to it. And so, yeah.
Actually, now that you mentioned that, I think people think that without people around, it should be less nerve-wracking. But which to you is more nerve-wracking, playing live in front of an audience or in front of cameras like this?
For me, it's in front of cameras.
I think it's during the start of the show, then I'll feel nervous. But then towards the end, I'm just like, oh, okay.
All right.
It's a show.
Yeah, it's like a show. It's regular. We just got to imagine that the tables and chairs are all filled with people, the atmosphere. But again, like I said, you don't know this, but everyone at home is like, ah, good job. They sound so amazing. Now, I just want to know, because you guys sound so good together, you guys must play for like a really long time together. So how long have you guys been playing together?
I think with Tasnim, I think it's 3 years now. Almost 3 years with Cliff, I think, what, 6-7 years, about there.
Wow, wow. So, because you guys have been playing, I would say it's been quite a while together. What do you think has been the hardest thing for you guys during this MCO as artists?
I think for me, the hardest thing is, about the whole MCO thing is not being able to go out and hang with friends. go to my favorite banana leaf restaurant and sit down and have makan and interact in that way. And also remaining motivated to keep on going and believing that, you know, a better day will come. Good will come out of this terrible thing that's been happening. But coming back to your question there, you know, working with no audience, at first it's a little bit strange, but I'm mindful that there are three people who are very important to me, and it really matters a lot what they think of what I play, and that is Tasneem, Cliff, and Dasha. And because they are there, you just have to play well, because they're there, because, you know, this is jazz. Sometimes you make mistakes nobody knows, and, you know, you make a mistake, you play it twice, and they think you intended to hit that note. But your fellow musicians on stage, they know. They know when you're messing up, and so, you know what? So for me, you know, they are the primary audience, and, you know, if they're happy with what I'm doing, then I'm very happy.
That is so sweet. And I can tell you guys are laughing, so it's kind of like, oh, we made mistakes, but you guys don't know. But speaking of that, actually, I'm kind of curious now that you pointed that out. How do you guys practice during MCO? Because you guys are all at home, and with the internet, sometimes there's lagginess. So even if you go on Zoom or WhatsApp video, you know, sometimes you're out of sync. So how do you guys practice?
We had a one-day rehearsal before the show. Like, we just kind of met up at his place to have a rehearsal. Then, yeah, that's just basically it. But other than that, it's just most of the time we're just at home, just practicing and all, at least for me. Like, I mean, now during the MCO, I have more time. And to tell you the truth, I kind of love it because I finally get to practice as much as I can. And, you know, been working on recordings and stuff like that, getting like mics or whatever, testing out experiment around and all. And one of the reasons, actually, Mike was the one who inspired me to do that. Yeah, like from his live Chao video, when he was saying that, you know, it's, you just have to create, keep on creating. And that kind of inspired me to do that. So just basically that, so yeah.
That's absolutely amazing. And I think, like, to feed off what you said earlier, sometimes it's so hard during these circumstances to stay motivated, and especially as creatives, I think to keep it going, to be able to practice our craft and really work on it, is really hard during these circumstances. So kudos to you guys for always keeping up that spirit of creating and, of course, sharing your craft of music. I think I want to ask, you know, is this your first time doing a live broadcast like this?
Yes.
Yes?
Yeah, definitely, yes. with the band, yes. I had the privilege to do the Chao Team Live at Home thing. And yeah, for me, yes. But just like to say a quick shout out to some very key people. Thank you, John of Chao Team, for having us. And thank you, Alex of Starmount. So this wonderful sound that you're hearing is from Alex of Starmount Studios and the video crew who are here as well and doing this. So, you know, we're not alone. To do something like this, it requires a team. And, you know, John, you put together a fantastic team. Thank you very much. And thank you, each and every one of you at home, for joining us this evening.
Guys, now, of course, people at home, like what Michael has said, you may not be able to see it unless we go to the big live camera behind. You'll actually see a couple of them behind screens, cameras, audio, visual, and everything. You can see them waving right now. Kudos to them for putting all of this together, because without them, we definitely would not have this broadcast today. Woo! Now, speaking of our broadcast, I think everyone is kind of excited to see the second half, so let's get ready for it. Ladies and gentlemen, Well, they are getting into positions. Guys, make sure you keep those comments coming onto any platform that you are on. And of course, any platform that you're on, make sure you give us a like, a comment, subscribe, follow, so that you're always up to date with all of our notifications, our lives, and of course, when we start to gather back here one day at the Jiao Team, okay? And of course, for those of you who are just joining, in case you don't know, okay, the best video and audio quality is actually on YouTube. You can find the link on our Facebook Live link, or you can simply search Jiao Team on YouTube and you should be able to find us. There would be a small little video that says, "We are live." As you can see, the crew, everyone's just like trying to settle everything as we continue. So please do stay tuned. All right, and of course, again, this is actually an initiative set up by Jiao Team in support of our struggling performers during this pandemic. So if you'd like to contribute to our donations, you can visit our website, www.jiaoteam.com. And all of the information will be there. And we just want to say thank you in advance for contributing, for your kindness. And of course, we're filled with gratitude, as like all our performers have mentioned today. All right, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, are you guys good? Are you guys ready to serenade with more jazz tunes?
Yes.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the Michael Virpin Trio. Thank you.
chick career called The Mad Hatter Rhapsody. It's quite a Mad Hatter type song. We're going to continue now with one of Cliff's favorite songs. And this is from the late, great jazz flautist, Dave Valentine. And this one is called Oasis.
Thank you.
That's Cliff Wong on drums and Tasneem Bulhassan on bass. And now, bring you back on stage, the wonderful Dasha Logan.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, Michael Verpin on the piano.
Thank you.
Here's a song I would like to dedicate to myself. Written by Mr. Cole Porter. What is this thing called love, this funny thing called love? Just who can solve its mystery? Why does it make a fool of me? I saw you there that wonderful day. You took my heart and threw it away. That's why I asked the Lord in heaven above, what is this thing called love? What is this thing called love? This funny, funny thing called love. Just who can solve its mystery? Why does it make a fool of me? Above, what is this thing called by Mr. Anthony Strong, and a little bit of our little twist as well.
Really?
That was fun. Here's an Esperanza Spalding tune. Thank you.
asking me where you think I'm not looking, tells me your heart's a sleeping giant. What about some boy you love it for me? I see you're scared, unconvinced by what I'm trying to say. Is I am yours and that nothing will take me away. Never say it again. I love you, baby. Nothing will take me away. The way you always call me with some questions, and every time try to pretend you didn't call me just 'cause I was on your mind. It's too soon for you to say out loud, but I know you love me, and though you don't say it, already shows. You already know. Never say it again. I love you, baby. Nothing will take me away. I know that you never say it again. I love you, baby. Nothing will take me away. I know that you never say it again. I love you, baby. Nothing will take me away. I'll wait for you to open up. But it's not a boy. You're just what I've been looking for. Why do you keep your head? Whoever you loved before me, that brand's nothing like me. Nothing like me. She's nothing like
I'm sure.
still unspoken.
Oh well,
we'll catch up some other time. Just when the fun is starting, comes the time for parting. Still we'll be glad for what we have. And what's to come, there's so much more embracing. Still to be done, but time is wasting. Oh well, we'll catch up some other time. Just when the fun is starting, comes the time for parting. Still we'll be glad for what we have and what's to come. Some other time. I personally love that song because you can sing it just to about anybody that you haven't seen in a long time. It's also my brother's favorite song. We're gonna pick it up a little bit. Here's a fun tune by the Jackson 5. Pull out your best Michael Jackson moves, guys. Can't see you. Don't be shy.
Yeah, let's go.
Never can say goodbye. No, 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 I never can say goodbye. Even though the pain and heartache seem to follow me wherever I go, though I try to hide my feelings, try to say you're leaving me, I always have to say no. Tell me why. Is it so? I never can say goodbye. No, 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 no. I never can say goodbye. Every time I think I've had enough and start heading for the door, there's a very strange vibration piercing me right to the core. It says, turn around, you fool. You know you love it, bye-bye. Tell me why. Is it so? Don't wanna let you go. I never can say goodbye, boy. I never can say goodbye. No, 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 no. Oh, I never can say goodbye, boy. I never can say goodbye. No, 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 no. Never can say goodbye. No, 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 no. I never can say goodbye. Keep thinking that our problems sooner all gonna work out, but there's the same unhappy feeling, there's that anguish, there's that doubt. It's the same old dizzy hang up, can't do with you or without. Tell me why. Is it so? Don't wanna let you go. I never can say goodbye, boy. I never can say.
Change.
Can't realize you ever care. That was You've Changed, one of the saddest songs I've ever sung in my life. Oh. Trying to get out of that. That was You've Changed. Hope you liked it. We're gonna pick it up a little bit. Shake that off. We're gonna do a little Aretha for you. Well, this is her version. Gonna give you a little bit of love then. We want you to get involved. Put your hands together. Clap your hands. Put your hands. Say, baby, I love it.
Baby, I love it.
Baby, I need you.
Baby, I need
you. Baby, I love it. Baby, I need you. Come on, guys. You can sing through those masks. Sing louder at me. I want to hear you. One more time. Everybody ready? Are you ready at home? Sing with me. Say, baby, I love it. Baby, I need you. Baby, I love you. Baby, I love you. Baby, I need you. Baby, I love you. Woo! Baby,
Miss Aretha Franklin, that one. Up next, we're gonna do a song about... Oh, okay, about love that's just so passionate that it just gets a little too hot to handle. Kinsey report, every average man you know much prefers his lovey-dovey to court where the temperature is low. When the thermometer goes way up and the weather is sizzling hot, Mr. Pants for romance is not. 'Cause it's too darn hot. It's too darn hot. Baby, it's too darn hot. It's driving me. Too darn hot. Arrangement by Adam Strong. That's about the window, wasn't it? Woo! We know what that's like. Here's a tune by Mr. Duke Ellington for you. Been singing this version arranged by Mr. Michael Verpin. Night and stars above and shine so bright. The mystery of your fading light that shines upon our caravan. Sleep upon my shoulder as we creep across the sand so I may keep this memory of our caravan.
Shine so bright, the mystery of your fading light that shines upon our caravan. Oh, sleep, sleep, sleep upon my shoulder as we creep across the sand. So I may keep this memory of our caravan. Tuning in. Stay safe. Thank you. Good night. Don't go anywhere.
Wow, 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 ladies and gentlemen, Michael Verpin Trio featuring Dasha Logan. What an incredible set. And honestly, what a relaxing way to start our weekends for all of us at home. Guys, absolutely amazing. Seriously, give it up for our performers tonight. Give them virtual applauses and lots of love.
Thank you.
And of course, thank you everybody for staying tuned, no matter what platform, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. We thank you all and we hope you guys have definitely enjoyed. And of course, thank you to all of you who have donated to our initiative. If you guys still want to donate, our website is always open. It's 24/7, okay? www.jiaotim.com. And all the proceeds and donation will actually be going to our performers, Michael, Tasnim, Cliff, and Dasha. In fact, they will be back tomorrow. Michael, Verpin, and the trio. Three of you guys will be back tomorrow. Like what Dasha said, with a new singer, Samantha DeLune.
Ooh.
Spoiled
surprise.
Why?
I thought I spoiled surprise, but it's already pending. You can already queue up for the live. Right?
Oh, yes! And because of that, ladies and gentlemen, make sure you set your timers, your reminders on all of our social media platforms because we will be back again tomorrow at 9 p.m. Yes, yes, yes. So, guys, we will see you guys again tomorrow. Thank you so much, Dasha, and again, we hope to see you guys tomorrow again. Set your timers. My name is Dana, and it has been an absolute pleasure to be hosting for you today. And until tomorrow, make sure you guys stay home, stay safe, and stay clean. Good night.